Mommy, Daddy, why don't I look like you? Well, sweetie, when your dad and I crossed, single recessive epistasis took place. What is that? Let's call Professor Mouse. I heard you have a question about epistasis. What would that be? Mr. Mouse, why don't I look like my mom and dad? That is a wonderful question, Tilly. Give me a second to share my screen with you to better explain. Ah, there we go. All right, Tilly, before we begin, let me give you a little background information on epistasis, but more specifically, single recessive epistasis. Simply put, epistasis is when the alleles that are expressed at one locus masks or modifies the alleles that are expressed in another locus. You can think of it as stealing the spotlight in a sense. There are about six modes of epistasis, but we are going to only focus on single recessive epistasis since that's what's happening in your case. This is when a homozygous recessive allele masks the alleles at another locus, whether it be dominant, recessive, or both. Now that we cover the basic definitions, I want to cover the real science behind why you look different to your parents, and even what your offspring will look like, Tilly. You see here how your mom and dad crossed and came out with you? If you hadn't noticed, all your siblings also look like you and have the same gene sequence. This is because your father, being pure black, and your mother, being pure white, can only make your coloring due to the alleles present. However, if you cross with your siblings, you would produce all three colors in a ratio of 9 to 3 to 4. But Mr. Mouse, why would my offspring come out in different colors? Good question. Let's take a look here at this pathway I drew for you. You'll start with a colorless precursor, which is your mom's coloring. Think of this as a scratch piece of paper. You can leave it or change it. In order to be white, you would need to not have enzyme A present, which makes the B locus not even matter since you can never get to black if you lack enzyme A. If the A allele is functional to form enzyme A, it will make a black pigment, such as what your dad looks like. Now, if there is a functional B allele to make enzyme B, you can get your color, Tilly, or goatee, as I will refer to it. However, if there is a lack of enzyme B, the color will remain black. This is why you came out of goatee, Tilly. Enzyme B was present as well as enzyme A, thus making you that color. Since the pathway can get kind of confusing, let's think about it like a diatomic cross. Since you'll be crossed with someone of the same gene sequence, the cross will look something like this. As you can see, both loci are heterozygous, and based on a dihybrid cross, you would come up with a ratio of 9 to 3 to 3 to 1. I also showed you what colors would appear based on the outcome. I see two of the combinations result in an albino color. Why do we separate them? Good catch. Based on the dihybrid cross, you would think you would have four phenotypes to observe, since we got four different combinations. However, we only observed three. So the fact that we didn't observe four phenotypes suggests that some combinations of genotypes can give the same phenotype. As you can see, I combined the numbers to make four, which is actually the typical ratios present in simple recessive epistasis. Does this make sense to you, Tilly? Yes, sir. Thank you so much. You're welcome. Goodbye now. Goodbye. And here are my resources.